When you come to the operation theater, you have to think about the etiquettes that have to be followed. First of all, the slippers, outdoor slippers, have to be removed. As you come to the theater, as you know, you have to change into the theater dress, and importantly, you have to wear the theater slippers. Before entering the theater, you must wear your cap. Now, cap can be worn even before you wear theater dress to avoid hair falling onto your dress. So, if the cap is worn, then the hair are well covered. For ladies, the girls who have long hair, they have to take special precaution to make sure that the hair are well covered. Once the cap has been worn, you have to wear the mask. Now, mask is for your own protection as well as of the protection of the patient. Now, for your own protection, because sometimes there's a bleeder and blood may spill over onto your face. So you have to wear a mask. And in some cases, you may have seen disposable masks where they have a plastic visor which covers you on the eyes also. So some of you may have been to theater and have realized that during operation, blood can actually come into your eyes. Small spots can go into the eyes. So therefore, there are visors. So this is cap, mask, and theater change. As you enter, you have to think about your ornaments. You shouldn't really have a lot of ornaments on you. So if there's a ring, then that ring needs to come out and securely placed. And as you enter the theater, then you have to respect the theater atmosphere. The mobiles must be on silent. Fancy ringtones and those sorts of things must not happen. There is a team play here. So you have to respect the theater nurse. You have to have your assistants, the anesthetist, and in some cases, the pediatrician. There is an assistant nurse, sometimes a runner, because there are various other things to be done in theater. So it's a team play, and you have to make sure that each team member is made comfortable. So as you come into theater, there is an operation theater table. Then there is an anesthetic machine that's just behind you. You have the endoscopy stack system you can see there, in which you have the monitor, you have the light source, you have the camera drive unit, insufflator, and various electrical energy diathermy machines. On this side, this is the anesthetic machine, a very important member of your team. So they need to know the details of the case so that they can do the necessary treatment from the top end. So anesthetists must be aware of what surgical procedures are being done. Obviously, before you start any surgical procedure, you must speak to the theater nurse. And theater nurse, can you please come there? So once the theater nurse is there, we will take the stool aside, please. You will discuss the trolley. You will make sure that all the right instruments are kept. You will make sure that the gown has been kept, and you would want a 7-number glove. So that 7-number glove, has it been kept, 7-number? No. So we need to have a 7-number glove. So can you give me a 7-number glove? Okay. So before going to scrub, please open the glove and drop it onto the trolley. Make sure that your glove and your gown and whatever you need is all available. With this, now you're ready to go to the scrub area. But in the meantime, the theater nurse will probably have the patient in the room, and they will have to give the right position, put the return plate. Those are important things for the theater team to follow to give the right position. And of course, the anesthetist will start doing the job. In the meantime, the surgeon should go to scrub himself.